Powers of the chosen people.
Strongholds. What we're trying to pull down is the word over seven. People's eyes.
And pain before my eyes. Broken people wanting to believe in something. Looking for a light. Trying to find a truth.
And hold themselves not guilty.
But we give them that saying we do something we don't. Hurting people saying we do things that we won't. Wolfish these clothing with a cross on his chest. Taking people money, promising to be blessed. But power to the chosen people, who at one point wasn't viewed as an equal. His own chosen people, royal priesthood. Yeah. That you've been called out of the dark into the marvelous light. Do you know who you are?
Royalty.
I'm talking to you, sister. Discern. Don't get fooled. Christianity has destroyed
only
people.
And here are the examples of what you have done to us.
Acts chapter 11 and verse 11.
Now the question is about the Ethiopian, right? He was a Gentile. He was a Jewish.
He was saved salvation by having faith in Jesus.
And it's so good to pass.
And it's going to happen in the future. Read on.
And that day that the Lord shall set his hand against the second time to recover the remnant of his people.
That's what he was explaining. God was set his hand a second time to recover his people.
Which shall be left from Assyria, from Egypt, from Petros, from
Kush, where's Kush?
He's distracting you.
What is Kush? No. That's my question. Kush? Where's Kush?
It's in Ethiopia.
Thank you. That's left in Ethiopia. Read on.
And from Elam.
And from Elam.
And from Shinar.
And from Shinar.
And from Hamath.
And from Hamas.
And from the islands of the sea.
And from the islands of the sea. Read on.
And he shall set up an ensign.
For who?
For the nations. And shall assemble the outcasts of Israel.
Boom.
Of Israel!
So who's going to be scattered? You're going to have in Kush, which is in Ethiopia.
Exactly. And that was fulfilled when the Ethiopia was saved. And it was fulfilled when the Ethiopia was saved.
Is raise up the black men today to come back in their rightful place.
Right.
And men like this is
Jesus loves
themselves.
Black
keep
people.
Quiet.
Jesus loves black people.
How did you
say
that?
We're not even talking to you no more.
So why did Jesus save the Ethiopian?
Who said about saving the black people?
What?
Or destroyed for a lack of knowledge?
This is destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Where is Cyrene?
You have self-hatred.
Where is Cyrene?
You hate the Drake.
Who have Jesus carry his cross?
My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Because that has rejected knowledge.
Because you rejected the word of God. You asked the brother, why are you reading on and on? He got to Nehemiah and say, he give you the understanding here.
Wait a minute.
You don't want to hear the word. You are the devil.
There's no answer.
You are.
How do you guys get saved?
Black people.
No, you can't accept. We are teachers. You listen.
Read. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Because thou has rejected knowledge.
Because you reject God's word.
No,
don't ask no more questions. When you ask the question,
about
the answer, and you got another question.
I will also reject you.
Galan, we reject you. We don't want to hear you.
Christianity
has destroyed all people. Black man, it's time for you to wake up. Black man, give me one of your feet. Christianity has destroyed people.
Read.
Chapter 13 and verse 11. And that knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep.
You know what the sleep is? Christianity is asleep. Y'all got all people under amazement. How many times we've been out here for hours reading scriptures? You can't cannot fool us.
Are you saying that salvation is only for salvation? Nearer than we believe.
Because of Are you saying that salvation is only for black people?
To confuse us. Where we started with it, wherever it's confusion
is. Yes, that's why you're saying that.
So now we are here teaching people to get right. Don't commit
adultery. You are promoting racism.
We're promoting God's
truth. You are promoting racism.
Okay, racism is one person is better than another, right?
No.
What? Deuteronomy 28.
You are saying that only black people can be saved.
7-6.
Let's go to Acts 15.
I got it.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6.
Read.
For thou art an holy people.
You know what it means to be a holy people to God above all nations?
Unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee.
He chose you out of everybody
to be a special people unto himself.
Read on.
Above all people. Above.
He made you be equal everybody.
Above all people.
Stop that. Give me. Get read on.
Upon the face of the earth.
So God said all people are going to be above others. Give me Deuteronomy 26:19. Above all people on the face of the earth. And you know what that means? Give me John 1:3-1. You know what that means, black man? You know how great you are.
Yes, we are all great when you are saying Jesus Christ. White Jesus.
Deuteronomy.
Let me see.
I didn't say Jesus Christ. He was a Jew. So now you're cursing
Deuteronomy 26, verse 19. And to make thee high above all nations.
To make us high above all nations.
Which he have made.
Out of all nations he meant to be high above them. Read on.
And praise.
And praise.
And in name.
And name.
And in honor.
And honor. We the Israelites.
That's right.
We're above all nations in the sun.
That's right.
Can I ask you a question? If you are an Israelite,
First John 3:1. Behold, the manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us.
You know the manner of love the Lord bestowed upon you. That what?
That we should be called the sons of God.
You know what it means to be called a son of God.
To have faith in
Israelite.
Jesus.
You're above all nations, and then you got counterproductive niggas like this.
Then
bring
it
back Therefore, the world don't know us. That's why you confused. You don't know who we are.
We don't know who you are.
Because it knew him not. Because
you don't know Christ, and you don't know the scripture.
They live under the law.
You just cursed Christ.
Let me ask you a question.
You just cursed Christ.
Of the works of the law are under the curse.
Deuteronomy 27, verse 19, and to make thee high above all nations, which he has made, and praise.
I'm stopping. Sorry, guys. Your whole faith is screwed and cursed.
Sorry, guys. That effeminate spirit. That's Christianity. Galang, you demons. You ain't of God. God don't speak like that. Give me Isaiah 12:58. That's it. God don't speak like that.
Excuse me.
No, we don't want to hear.
Isaiah 58, verse 1.
You got it mixed up how the prophets of God were. You think Jeremiah was like that? Read.
Cry aloud.
What?
Cry aloud.
That's why we speak like that. The Bible said what?
Cry aloud.
Spare not. Isaiah 58:1.
Cry aloud. Spare not.
The Bible said we're supposed to cry aloud. We don't talk to you feminine.
Wait a minute.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
Lift your voice like a what?
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
That's why we speak like this. Christianity is coming. Where's the devil at?
Let me ask you one question.
Get into the Gentiles. You metrosexual. You feminine.
I can take on
anybody. Cry aloud. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet and do what? And show my people their transgression.
So show people what they're doing wrong. Give me Leviticus, the bear.
That the blessing of Abraham might come to the Gentiles.
Let me ask you a question, brother. You might receive the promise of the spirit of faith. This is the image of the beast. We're going to explain to you right now. Read.
Leviticus 21 and 4.
So we show people the chance. We're going to take the Lord's Sabbath day. We're going to put their binds, selling. Men are supposed to have fringes on. Men are supposed to have a beard on their face. Men are not supposed to act effeminate like a girl.
You call me a nigger?
Right
now, you're a Gentile. You got a Gentile state of mind. You want to follow the customs of the heathens. The heathens shave their beards all off. Every black anchor man on TV got no hair on his face. Look like a black milk dog. No hair, no facial hairs, no masculine features. Why? Because America want to effeminize our men. They want to say, you can't lift your voice up. You can't be masculine. All effeminate qualities. So continue to follow white man and break the laws of God. And see what happened to you. You gotta repent, man. It's just that simple. Apply God's laws.
I'm not following the white man. No more than you are.
Oh, yes, you are. You're following the white man in every aspect of your life.
What are you saying?
The Lord said, what? What are we gonna wear our clothes to bow? No, not our food to bow amongst the Gentiles.
It's the boots you got on.
Ezekiel 3 and 4.
All right, let's get that. Come on, bring that out. What's what?
What are your sandals?
Well, these are sandals.
Sir.
Hey, Sam, check out my sandals on right here. All right, how you like that?
Let your hair there.
You know? Where is it in the law that say I can't wear this? Show me. Because all you've been talking is your words. Now, I will go with it. If you have a valid response to anything that I do contrary to God's laws, I will take it into consideration to see if it's in God's law. Let's find it in the Bible. It's just the whole word, once again. They don't want to apply God's laws, but they're quick to tell you to do something that's not even biblical. Or tell you you're doing something wrong that's not even in the Bible. That shows you the ignorance of our people, man. They simple as hell, man. They need to wake up and apply God's laws. That's what they need to do, because death is coming to America. And you best believe it. He's going to start with them homos first.
Right.
You understand? He's going to snap them right in half. Come on, read what you got.
Ezekiel chapter 4, verse 14.
You think it's a joke, huh?
Then said I Lord God.
It's a joke.
I think you're a joke.
Behold, my soul hath not been
moved. Hey, everybody in America.
For from my youth up,
or the KKK,
even till now, have I not eaten of that which dieth of itself, or is torn in pieces.
So we don't eat swine. We don't eat pork. We don't eat anything contrary to the Levitical laws in this Bible. It's just that simple. You know? Let's get 1 Corinthians 6 and 9. You know, big abomination wearing girls' shoes. Where the hell you get them from?
These not girl shoes.
Bro, you Hold on, let me turn this for a check, nigga. These are space trains. You going to Boston? This nigga talking about that shoe. What the fuck? What he say? Get on your ass. I don't want to hear it. Don't touch him.
Notice that the righteous shall not inherit the kingdom. Y'all worried about it, right? I promise y'all cut out y'all motherfuckers. I am a man. Y'all hoes gonna be some fucking pussies today. You know what? The scripture says no unrighteous shall enter to the kingdom of heaven. Because what makes us a real man?
Nigga, we need to get on. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor effeminate, nor effeminate.
Everybody together.
If I know God, I love them.
That's not God right there.
Earlier you said that again, you kill us, right?
Not right
earlier you walked by, you said, man, God, you ordered them. That's earlier, right? Earlier you walked by,
mindset, my foot by the gun, I slaughtered him, dude. Wasn't that you that said that earlier? Is that you? Or somebody else?
Me, okay.
Oh, right. So that's, again, that shows our people despise themselves and despise them, their people.
Yeah. Right.
Now, you go into the Bible. When Christ
it says the same thing that it says right there.
Right. Now let me ask you a question. When the Messiah walked the earth, when they nailed him to the cross, right? He got nailed to the cross. They nailed through what?
His flesh.
What color was the flesh?
Amen.
It wasn't see-through. It wasn't rainbow.
Right.
It wasn't rainbow. Right. So some will say, well, some will say it's olive colored. Olive comes in three colors.
Yeah.
It comes in black, it comes in green, and it comes in brown.
Right.
So it obviously wasn't green. So you got two choices. You got black and you got brown, which goes to the same thing.
Yeah.
So what color was the flesh that was nailed to the cross?
Brown.
Which will make him a what?
Browns.
I want to hear him say it. A brother. Right. So when our people see their Messiah like a brother, they'll say it's the devil. For example, you buy some cake, right? It'll be white cake. What do they call white cake? They call it what food? What do they call chocolate cake?
Devil cake.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's what they call it.
That's
what he said earlier.
That's reality.
That's the slave mind once again.
Right,
that's the slave mind once again. White cake is good cake. Black cake is devil cake.
Yeah.
So you walked in and said that's the devil. That's the mindset. That's your mindset right there.
I didn't read the bottle.
Oh, okay.
Because I read the bottle and I seen that in the Bible.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
All this is
right. But what I seen, when I looked at him,
right,
it wasn't him.
Right.
What I'm thinking about.
Gotcha.
When I read this right here, it's in the Bible.
Gotcha. Yeah. Now, understand. This is not what I'm saying is him. It's a depiction of him.
Yeah.
You understand? It's a depiction. A black man, white woolly hair,
right,
hair thorns, red eyes, green garment, or barrel. Give me that real quick. It's a depiction. We're not saying this is actually him. But we do know, according to the Bible description, he's a black man with woolly hair, white woolly hair, and dark skin.
Darker than this. You never knew what color he was.
No. See, I asked you earlier. I asked you earlier, brother.
Saying they never knew what color he was, though.
Who didn't know what color he was?
Whoever made it?
Remember what I asked you earlier? What's your name?
Joel?
Noel.
Yeah.
Noel. I said Noah.
Yeah.
When they nailed him to the cross, when they nailed to the cross,
he nailed his flesh.
So they had to have seen what he looked like, brother.
Yeah,
you can't nail. I don't see you. I'm going to nail what I cannot see. That make no sense. They had to have seen him. People walked up to him and said, "Oh, that's the Messiah." Remember, they walked up to him crying. Someone seen what happened.
Yeah.
They watched him. Mm-hmm. Read that, please. Hold that. Get John 19:19. I'm gonna show you people saw him. Because the misconception is that no one has ever seen the Messiah. That's the misconception. No one has seen him. We know he's the Messiah based on not seeing him. He performed miracles when no one saw it. Before you do, let me read this verse. Daniel 10 verse 5.
Daniel chapter 10 verse 5. Then I lifted up mine eyes and looked.
This is Daniel seeing the Messiah in a vision. Prior to his birth.
And behold, a certain man clothed in linen.
He saw a certain man in his vision clothed in linen. Linen made of linen garments. Right. Go ahead.
Whose loins were girded with the fine gold of Uphaz.
We have a linen girdle. He had a golden girdle around his waist. Go ahead.
His body was like the beryl.
Beryl was green. He had a green garment on. Green. Beryl. Go ahead.
And his face as the appearance of lightning.
He had light around his body because it's the Son of God.
And his eyes as lamps of fire. His eyes as lamps of fire.
Redness. Go ahead.
And his arms.
And his socks. Slow. And now he had a garment on. His arms are visible. And he wore sandals, so his feet are visible. Read it again.
And his arms.
And his arms.
And his feet.
And he saw his feet.
Like in color.
Stop. Like in what?
Like in color.
If it's written, it matters.
Wow.
Right. Go ahead. So I say, hold on. Go ahead.
To polish brass.
To what?
To polish brass.
The color is brass.
The color is brass.
Brass is brown.
Brass is like on here, like a tan.
Right. Brown.
Yeah.
You're saying tan as if he was Caucasian with tan skin.
No.
Brown.
It's like it's copper.
Right.
exactly.
Yeah, like a penny. Copy. Yeah, like a penny.
Right.
Yeah.
Now let's get some more detail on that Brown, Revelations 1. Watch this. Let's see how brown the copper was. So you take a penny and you put it under fire, what color is it turn?
Black.
Right. So if I take white rice, put it under fire, what happens to the rice?
It burns.
Macaroni and cheese.
It burns.
A person.
It burns.
Look, what color is it?
Brown.
You get burnt.
No, it burnt.
Burnt is what?
Black.
Right. Burnt white?
It's like ashes.
Right, but it's still black. Starch.
It's still black.
Right.
Yeah, starch.
Revelation chapter 1, verse 14.
Right.
His head. Revelation chapter 1, verse 10. I was in the spirit of the Lord's day.
Today, Sabbath day.
And heard behind me a great voice as a trumpet.
Now, John, he heard behind him a great voice. So he's hearing it behind him. Go ahead.
Say, I am Alpha and Omega.
Go ahead.
The first and the last.
Go ahead.
And what thou seest, write in a book.
So what? He said, John, you turn around, what you see, write in a book. So what he's saying is important. Go ahead.
And send it unto the seven churches, which are in Asia.
Go ahead.
Unto Ephesus, unto Smyrna, unto Pergamos, and unto Thyatira, and unto Sardis, and unto Philadelphia, and unto Laodicea. And I turned to see the voice that spake with me.
So he turned around to see who was talking to him.
Go ahead.
And being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks.
He saw seven, brother, listen. Noel, listen. He saw seven, come on, hold on, let me show you something. He saw seven golden candlesticks.
That's
good. Right there. The Noah. Christ. So are you. But right here. Seven golden candlesticks, right? The brother said, he's repeating to you what the Bible says, what the Lord says.
But he said I can ask a question.
Listen. Now you said, I'm talking to you. You want me to talk to you or you going to talk?
I'm listening.
Okay, when you talk, I'm going to be quiet. So when I talk, you be quiet. You ready to talk? All right, talk.
I asked him, how do he know what color God is? What color Jesus is? We was not there. Let me talk. Books have been written thousands and thousands of times. You have changed it. The white man have changed it. The Muslim man has changed it. We was not there. You was not there. To say every black man is ignorant, I'm a black woman and I'm smarter than half the men on this street. Because one, my education gives me the right to believe what state the Statue of Liberty is. Anybody would say New York? No, it's not. So when you speak on black men, you also speaking of black people, period. God didn't put you here to tell me about me being gay, because if Adam and Eve wouldn't have ate from that tree, we wouldn't be like this. But it's my decision to be who I want to be.
Okay.
Now wait, let me finish talking.
Okay.
Now, my God is of everybody's God. We are all children of that God. I chose to be like this because I wanted to. You're not gonna judge me. She's not gonna judge me. I'm gonna wait till I die. Hold on, let me finish.
No, sister.
Let me finish. You believe when you die that your mother is watching over you. No, she's not. She's dead.
You finished. Now can I speak? You said nobody know what Christ look like. We're gonna prove that you're alive,
dear. No! That book has been
written. When you're talking, I'll be quiet, right?
No,
to show respect. To show you got demon on you, sister. All right, you see, when you were talking, I didn't say a word, did I?
I'm listening.
Okay, pay attention.
Pay attention.
Revelation 1. Since you said nobody know what color is quite, we're gonna prove that you're alive.
Right.
That demon that work on you is a lying demon.
That's right. Work.
Revelation 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The book Revelation means that revealing of somebody. Am I right?
Right.
You revealing somebody.
Revelation.
Revelation means you revealing. That's what that word means.
Okay,
revealing. Go ahead.
Which God gave unto him to shoot unto his servant thick.
Don't let that lawyer that you have.
Okay. Most I give Christ to reveal to John what's going to come to pass. Right?
Right?
Okay, go ahead.
And signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
Go ahead.
Who bear record of the word of God.
He bear witness. John was a witness of the word of God.
Right.
Now let's go. Let's go to what John witnessed. Listen, sister. John, when you are talking, I'll be quiet. You wanting it. I just saw word.
They was there.
What? Why now I'm talking, you talking over me?
Give me that 1 Corinthians 14 verse.
I'm going to show you got a demon on you, sister. I'm going to show you you're working with demons. I know you don't want to hurt it because you're going to die in your sin.
That's God.
You're going to die in your sin, sister. That's your God right here. That's who you worship. That's your God right here. That's why you don't know how to be in order, sister.
That's who you worship. That's who you worship. You can't tell me to be in order. He's not here to tell you who I am.
1 Corinthians 14, verse 40.
Let's listen to this.
Let all things be done decently and in order.
Am I was in order, sister, when she was talking? Am I was in order when she was talking? When I was in order when she was talking, I didn't say a word. Now I'm talking now, that demon wanna talk over me. Because sister, you're gonna die in your sin. You're gonna die in your sin.
You're gonna die too.
Let all things.
You gonna die? Everybody's gonna die.
Listen, the difference between me and you, I acknowledge my sin. Then I repent for my sin. You acknowledge you are lesbian, but you have not been repent. Then you're gonna die.
You know what I didn't been.
You are a lesbian, you're gonna die if you don't repent.
Are you my God?
Let all things be done.
Who words we? Hold on. Who words we been in our? My words or the word of Most High God?
The words of Most High God. I thought his name was Jehovah. He said you got a name. His name is Jehovah. He said you got
you know
a
all
name.
These
I got
things.
A name.
You know all these things, but you cannot stop.
But you cannot,
you cannot you cannot stop. Listen, you know all these wisdom, but you cannot stop making another sister.
I'm not going to heaven.
You have all this wisdom. You don't
so
know.
When you
sleep with another sister
heaven.
Is a sin.
We all going to heaven.
You
hell yeah, it's a sin. It's
so
a sin for
to
you to
about it? What you going to do about it?
Nothing. I'm gonna live my life.
You damn right. You're gonna die in your sin.
And you're gonna die too.
Right.
Let all things be done decently and in order.
Thank you. I know what the fuck.
Because you're not about repenting here. We're here for our people willing to change. You're not willing to change, sister. So head walk, keep walk.
You're praising the whole country.
That's why we're here. Teaching repentance to our people. You don't want to change why you're here.
This is America.
If you don't want to change your way, why you're here?
Because I'm here.
Keep watching.
I don't have to. This is America.
Repent,
this is America.
And be converted.
That's what the Bible says. Repent, he therefore, and be converted.
Okay,
now let's check
that.
The way of converted.
We know that. Sometimes but you acting like he's God.
No, sister, if you know it, you would have changed your ways already.
Oh, order to pray to God. Well, who you
that makes no sense.
To?
God created you, tell you, be fruitful and multiply. You go lick another woman, vagina. What did you want
to
do?
But you're not supposed to judge
sister,
me.
Man.
You're not supposed to
God
judge
God
me.
God
you
is judging me.
You're judging me.
God is judging you.
You're judging me.
I'm bringing the word of God
everybody
to you, sister. How the hell I'm judging you? The Lord God is judging you.
And if God didn't want me to be like this, he would have took me.
The
are you
Lord
crazy?
Of the Lord
are you crazy?
Is perfect.
Y'all heard what God
the
said? God's Lord is perfect, sister. When you apply God's Lord, you're going to be a perfect sister.
That's right.
You can be a simple for your other sister. But right now, you don't want to change. You want to continue being a lesbian. You want to continue being a homo. Guess what? Guess what, sister? Guess what? You're going to die in your sin.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
That's the
why
same
she don't want to become the perfect
over,
sister.
Over and over and over.
You
was not there to
let
say
me ask you a
that that's God.
Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question, sister. Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question, sister. You see that? You are talking to demon, man. She's a demon.
You, oh, and I guess you
you're
got,
a demon,
let me bow down to you.
The Lord,
listen, that's what the Lord said, sister.
Perfect.
God's laws is perfect.
You ain't even from that country.
Give me that scripture that God made me
look
like. Give me that scripture.
God bless your soul.
I'm going to show you that sister choose that way.
You got to pray to the Son before you get to the Father. And you're going to die too.
This is what God said.
No, that's what you said. That's what you said. You ain't even from that country.
So she don't, y'all don't move on out here thinking that God make her like that. She choose to be that way.
God didn't
because
she
wicked as hell.
God didn't make me like this.
Adam and Eve
made me like this.
Listen, no, the holy have a vow. The God has been
Didn't they eat from that tree?
That scripture said?
They ate from that tree.
This only have I found the God that made men upright.
God has made men upright.
Right.
Upright. Okay. Upright. Because of your lust, you become that demon
so
you are.
Right.
That makes you a lesbian because of your lust.
They break my ancestors. That's why black people
But they have sort of many
black people got what?
You see why?
Get out of here.
This is what we find out. God has made men upright. Soyster's sister was born upright. But because of her lust for other women, she clenched. She chose to be a lesbian.
Right.
Now we tell her sister she can repent, get her life together.
Right.
She hating us for that.
Recently stopped. Listen. They recently started bringing blacks and people of color into their religion. You understand? But the morons in the beginning, was the only white people. You understand?
Sure.
No! Yeah. What did the morons and them had a part to play in slavery? Yes, they did.
That's right.
They had slaves and they helped destroy the Negroes. Did the moron descendants and them destroy the people in Panama? The people in where are they from? El Salvador? Did the white man did that? Yes. Yes, he did. So now, let me get Jeremiah 22. Jeremiah 22.
Our people
we're going to read what the scripture says. The conquistadors came, and your people were all white people had a role to play in slavery. All white people helped destroy the Negroes here. You understand? Read.
Jeremiah chapter 22, verse 13.
Don't let the morons lie to you, man.
Woe unto him that buildeth his house by unrighteousness.
Because the white men have built his house on unrighteousness, including the morons. Mormons, or whatever the hell you want to call them. And all people that following after that garbage, they're going to die with them. You understand? Because Christ is coming back to judge and make war on this earth. Read.
And his chambers by Rome.
So the scripture says what? Read that again.
And his chambers.
Read it from the top.
Woe unto him.
The scripture says woe unto him. You know what woe means? Woe means death. You understand? Death unto him. Read on.
That buildeth his house by unrighteousness.
America was built on unrighteousness. The moment they had slaves, they helped to destroy our people. They are the descendants of their forefathers. You understand? Recently they come in the black community. When I see them, I chase them, I run them away, man. And they convert fools like this man right here. Because you are fool following after that garbage, man.
White man.
And his chambers by Rome that useth his neighbor's servants without wages.
Because they use our service without wages. You know what that's called? That's called slavery. No, let's see what Christ about slavery. Let's see what Jesus Christ said. You believe in Jesus Christ? All of you are believing in Jesus Christ. Let's see what Jesus Christ said. Revelation 13.
That's right.
Let's see what Christ said. Because the scripture said, woe unto him that doeth his neighbor's service without wages, and filleth a city in unrighteousness. Read what Jesus Christ said.
Revelation chapter 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear.
Read on.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
Read that again.
He that leadeth into captivity.
So this is what Jesus Christ said. He said, he that leadeth into captivity, read on.
Shall go into captivity.
Shall, meaning future tense. Shall go into captivity.
That's right.
That's thus says the Lord. So was not the so-called blacks, the so-called Hispanics, wasn't them led into slavery? Yes, they were. Yes, they were conquered and destroyed by the conquistadors.
That's right.
By the so-called white men. They were conquered and destroyed.
Right.
You understand? Because
right.
Our people follow the religion of our conquerors. You understand?
No.
As I said, the Mormons was usually secluded, like the Amish. You know, the Amish is secluded.
Amish.
And recently, they got some blacks that are trying to follow the Amish people.
Mm-hmm.
It is no different from the Mormons.
Right.
All right, now read that. Read the book of Nephi. Let's see what the Mormons said.
Second Nephi.
Oh, yeah,
let's see what he said, man.
Yeah,
Let's see what John Smith said about you, so-called Negro.
521.
Second Nephi 521. And he had caused the cursing to come upon them, yea, even a sore cursing because of their iniquity. For behold, they had hardened their heart against him, that they had become like unto flint. Wherefore, as they were white and exceedingly fair and delightsome, that they might not be enticing unto my people, the Lord did cause a skin of blackness to come upon them.
So the Moses, their book, the book that Joseph Smith wrote, says that it's a curse to have blackness, to have black skin.
That's right.
That's what they say. Their book says it's a curse, and this brother, he think he white, you know. Mm. But brother, you are an Israelite.
Trump's
you understand? Right. You from the tribe of Zebulun, you are not a white man. Mm. You understand?
That's right.
So the book of Nephi say that to have black skin is a curse. God give the black people a put.
We call
wicked and evil, we got a curse. That's what the Mormons teach. Now read.
Verse 22. And thus said the Lord God, I will cause that there shall be loathsome unto thy people, which means very ugly. And save they shall repent of their iniquity. And cursed shall be the seed of him that mixed with their seed, for they shall be cursed even with the same cursing. And the Lord spake it, and it was done.
That's why the Mormons never.
To the spirit of his son, Jesus Christ, that we are the Israelite.
That's right.
We are the sons and daughters of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's our name. Because you're not going to find African American in the Bible. You're not going to find Jamaican. You're not going to find Haitian. You're not going to find Puerto Rican. What you're going to find is Jacob have 12 sons, that we are the descendant of those 12 sons.
That's right.
We are the Israelite. Go back to the book of Lamentation. Before that, give me Isaiah 31, verse 1. Because you, what you seem to forget is, you got to understand is, you so-called black man, that you seeking justice in the wrong place. You are seeking justice in the wrong place.
Yes.
How long God will continue to put you to death in the middle of the street? The enemy kill you, but guess what you do? You go to the enemy for justice. That make no damn sense.
That's right.
That make no sense. So, let me get this straight. They come, they murder you. They murder you somewhere in front of you. And then you go and march. You go and march singing Kumbaya. And some of you are going to go vote next month. Guess what? Vote for who? The same man who put your son to death, you're going to vote for him in office. Why? Because you so-called leaders. Jesse Jackson. What is that, a cool name? Al Sharpton. Telling you to vote. Keep hope alive. No justice, no peace. How long are you going to be seeking that?
That's right.
The white man, the so-called white man, is laughing at you. Read what you got.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 31 and 1. Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help.
God said, woe, woe means destruction to them that go down to Egypt. Because America is a modern day Egypt.
That's right.
You're seeking justice from your oppressor.
Yes.
You're seeking justice from the same enemy who put your son, your daughters to death.
That's right.
You're seeking justice from the same man who lynched you.
That's right.
When you're going to wake up?
Right.
When you're going to wake up? How many signs did God got to give you?
Right.
When you're going to wake up? You sleep. Read that again.
Isaiah 31 and 1. Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help.
You go down to America for help.
Right.
You seeking America for help.
Right.
You ready right now? How come the cops don't get arrested? Nothing's gonna change. I don't care if they lock them up, put away the key. Which is not gonna happen, by the way. But guess what? That's not going to change a damn thing.
That's good.
Until you repent, come back to Most High God, nothing will change.
That's right.
You must know who you are. You must know that. We are more than what we say we are. We are the greatest people that's ever set foot in this same planet. Don't wait for them to tell you that. They will not tell you that. Read. And stay on horses and trust in chariots. You trust in America. You trust in the same man who put you in slavery.
Right.
The problem, you know what's the problem with you, a lot of you? You forgot who you're dealing with.
Right. That's right.
You forgot what this man done to your forefathers.
That's right.
You forgot we are the sons and the daughters of the slave trade.
That's right.
Some of you forget that. But guess what? All praise to Most High God. The Israelites gonna remind you who the enemy is.
That's right.
Some of you forgot who the enemy is. That's why I love the 60s. In the 60s, the black men and the black women know who the enemy was.
That's right.
Today, the black men think this is the Holy Land.
Right.
You forgot how you was brought here. You was brought here in slave cargo ship.
Right.
And you're seeking justice. This is the same man that's lynched your father. This is the same man that's raped your daughters. You're seeking justice in the wrong place. You're seeking justice. All the black men and the black women know how to do. You're going to raise your hand. Hands up, no shoot. That's not going to change a damn thing until you repent.
That's right.
That's not going to change nothing. I'm telling you, shut up, black woman. The white man is laughing at you. They are thinking we're a bunch of jokes.
Bring it down.
I'm telling you, shut up. And you know why they think that? A couple of months from now, you're going to act like this has never happened.
Right.
2 weeks.
2 weeks from now, you're going to act like this has never happened.
Right.
Some of you, you forget about Trevor Martin. You forgot about that man in New York who got choked to death by the police.
Eric Garner.
You forgot. You see that? Come stand here, put your hands up, take pictures. While the enemy's laughing at you.
Put it on Facebook. That's what they want.
And you're going to put that in Facebook. You see, I did something. You ain't doing a damn thing.
Yes,
right. We the Israelite, we're here to give you the solution.
Right.
Some of you don't want the solution. Because you still love the enemy.
Bring it up.
You're in love with the enemy.
Bring it up.
That's why you don't want no solution. That's why some of you hate the Israelite.
Bring it up.
We're going to tell you the truth. Give me John 8:32. Give me what Christ said. Christ the black Messiah, what he said about the truth. Our people don't want to hear the truth.
Bring it up.
You want to hear lies. That's why you've been going to the Christian church. Your pastor has been teaching you lies for centuries. You got a Christian church in every corner in the black community. But we still shooting each other every day. Cops still shooting us down and on the streets in the broad daylight.
That's right.
Brought their life.
Right.
They're killing our children.
Yeah.
But all you're going to do is stand there, take a picture.
Wow.
You a damn joke.
Right. Yes.
Read, read the book of John, chapter 8 and verse 32. And ye shall know the truth. Jesus Christ said, you shall know the truth.
Right.
Today, you're going to find out who you are. You are more than they tell you are.
That's right.
Read that again. And ye shall know the truth. And the truth shall make you free. The black men and the black women, you don't want to be free. You want to stay here in Babylon. But Jesus said, you shall know the truth. And the truth shall make you free.
That's right.
The million-dollar question is, what is the truth?
Right.
What is the truth, black man? What is the truth, black woman? What you gonna do? The white man said, I'm gonna kill you, son, in broad daylight, right in front of you. What you gonna do?
Right.
What you gonna do? You gonna walk down and forth, we shall overcome? That's what I told you earlier. We the Israelite, we ain't gonna march. We ain't gonna vote. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna go to every state. We're gonna go to every city. We're gonna tell you to repent or you're gonna die. We're gonna tell you plainly, that is the gospel. We're gonna tell you, black men, black women, it's time to come out of sleep. We're gonna tell you, black men, black women,
repent. 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 That's why you see, who's running their mouth down there, the black woman?
What?
She's not saying a damn thing.
That's right.
I'm going to make them feel good.
What?
The angel are not here to make you feel good.
That's right.
We're here to tell you the truth.
That's right.
Lamentations chapter 4 and verse 17. As for us, our eyes has yet failed for our vain help.
As for us, our eyes are failed. Your eyes has failed, you black man. You seeking help in the wrong places.
Right.
You seeking help from the same men who put you in slavery. You seeking help from the enemy. How in the hell I kill your son, now you come to me for justice.
Right.
That made no damn sense.
Bring it out.
That make no sense. Basically, you said to me, you kill my son, now you gotta put yourself in jail. That make no damn sense.
Right.
That's a stupidity. But I'm gonna take picture. The question I have for you, you so-called Negro today, what you gonna do about what happened?
That's right.
Are you gonna continue to march? Are you gonna continue to walk down the street singing Kumbaya? Are you gonna continue to put your hands up? Hands up, don't shoot. A month from now, it's gonna happen all over again.
You gotta come out of the selfish spirit. We as black men have learned we've been so oppressed, we just wanna get any crumb we can and hold on to it, man. Come on.
And all that belief, we're together.
Stop. It says all that belief. But a lot of people don't know, because in Christian church, this is what their doctrine is. They'll tell you, just believe in Jesus and you're good. But they don't tell you how to believe. Now I want that. I want that. Ecclesiastes 32, verse 24. Because in order for us to believe, there is action behind the belief. How can I say that I believe in you, but I talk behind your back evil about you? How can I say that I love you when I allow others to what? Assassinate your character. How can I allow that? Because we don't know what it means to believe. The Bible teaches us how to believe in Christ. How to keep the commandments through his death. Watch this, come on.
Sirach 32:24.
I'm glad you're listening, brother. This message is fine in his heart. Come on.
He that believeth in the Lord.
Hold up.
La oportunidad de seguir.